Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen. It's Thursday, the 13th of September, 2012, and I've got a couple of video updates here for you. Starting off, cell phones. Talking on cell phones while driving. I've been noticing a lot of that lately. We need to knock that off. People driving around talking on the cell phones, that takes care of making you distracted when it comes to your driving. And that can cause accidents and all sorts of problems. So please, do not be operating a vehicle on this installation while talking on a cell phone. You might notice today a lot of the Marines walking about the base. They're just doing a standard patrol exercise. Those weapons are not loaded, so there's nothing to worry about. But they do that periodically in order to do their training and keep their proficiency up in case they should ever be called upon to go into harm's way. So. That's why you see the Marines out about the base today in their full camouflage and carrying their weapons around. All right, coming up this weekend on the 15th and 16th is the NEX Bazaar. You might have noticed that the parking has been secured over at the Fleet Recreation parking garage. That's because it's going to be full of vendors. About 80 vendors going to be in here this weekend. So this is a good opportunity for you to go over and buy some unique stuff here from the Asian Pacific realm. So both Saturday and Sunday, the NEX Bazaar will be going on. Next week, we start the CFC campaign. That's Combined Federal Campaign. So that starts on the 17th, and it runs into November. Opportunity to give to your favorite charities and do some contributions that way. On the 19th, we're going to be having an open galley for lunch over at, of course, our base galley. That'll be lunchtime. Go over there, 4:55, all you can eat. Anybody can go in. It's a good time. The theme for this month is Hispanic Heritage Month, and that's what the food's going to be like. There's going to be burritos and enchiladas and all things of that nature. So take advantage of that and go to the galley on Wednesday of next week, the 19th. On the 21st will be the Ombudsman Appreciation Dinner. So if you Ombudsman haven't gotten signed up for that yet, there's still time. Get your last tickets in there. They do such great work for us year-round, and we only get to appreciate them one time a year, and that is going to be on the 21st over at the O Club. So, Ombudsman Appreciation Dinner on the 21st of September. Also on the 21st of September, if you're interested in participating in the Honcho Patrol will be that evening. You assemble down at the main gate around 21:30 that night, more like 2200, and you can go out and help pick up trash and contribute to the community with the Honcho Patrol. On the 29th of September, if you're into Earth Day, Earth Day Part 73 is going to be on the 29th of September. So those who participate in the Earth Day events, that's coming up here again soon. And then on the 13th of October is a big event for us. It's the birthday ball. This is the 237th anniversary of the Navy. So our birthday ball will be over at Purdy Gym. We can get as many as 1,000 people in there. Tickets are on sale now, so if you want to go to the Navy birthday ball, go get your tickets. I'm told that the Muffin Man has not purchased his yet, so there should be plenty of tickets still available. On the 21st will be our next open base event. It's the Mikoshi Parade. That's when they start carrying the Mikoshis from out in town, and they wind up finishing up here on the installation on the base. That is going to be on the 21st of October, open base event Mikoshi Parade. Running from now through the 28th of September, you'll be hearing us doing some testing of the giant voice system, trying to get that thing tweaked and peaked and working fully operationally. So you'll hear some intermittent testing of the giant voice system between now and the end of the month. Also, what just opened, it'll be running through the 27th of September, is the Operation Tomodachi photo exhibit at the Community Relations Center, which is down there at main gate area down there at Kearney Gate is where the Cultural Exchange Center is, and that's where that's being held at. There's pictures, there'll be videos, they're giving out some free information. So if you're interested in going down and looking at some of that at the Cultural Exchange Center, that'll be running through the end of the month as well. Captain's Cup Sports in September. Here, the big one that's going to be starting up next week is Co-Rec Bowling. Sign-ups had to be done by the 12th, so you should have your teams together. The actual first bowling event is on the 17th. So commands, get your teams together, get out there, do some co-rec bowling, dust out the gutters, knock down some pins, and let's see if we can knock off subgroup 7 in the mouth that can't be ignored, Lauren. All right, if you want to beat the heat, here on coming up this weekend on the 14th at 0600 on Friday, if you want to jump into Green Bay, that's what we're going to do over there by the McDonald's. The Green Bay Beat the Heat Bay swim. So if you're daring and want to jump into the water over there, be over there by 0600 on Friday morning. And for the runners on the 26th of September at 11:30 over at Purdy Gym, there'll be the Suicide Awareness 5K. This month is Suicide Awareness Month. So the Suicide Awareness 5K will be ran on the 26th of September. Hey, the high schools are back in. The high school football has already started up, and Kinnick has a home game tomorrow night. Both the JV and varsity, they'll be playing the American school in Japan. 16:30 or 4:30 to you civilian types will be the JV game, and 19:30 or 7:30 p.m. for the varsity will take the field. And then the following day on the 15th over at the Kinnick Gym at 10:00, the volleyball team will be playing. Remember, they have won the championship the last 2 years straight, and they're going to start trying to go down the championship road once again with their first games here at home on Saturday. All right, on to the trivia from my last show. It's been a while since I made a video because I was out of country for a couple weeks, so these are a little old. But on the last show, I asked, what film featured the Triple Lindy? And that was Back to School with Rodney Dangerfield, the man who gets no respect. And that answer came from Tisha and Rob Takaras. Thank you for that answer. One of the songs I was looking for was Cletus Judd's How Do You Milk a Cow? And the answer for that one came from Jeremy Latimer. And the sports question was how many bowl games are going to be played next season? And appropriately, Coach Jolly from the high school football team gave me the correct answer for that one. So thank you, Coach. One of the songs I put out in the last trivia did not get answered, so I'm going to do that one again. Here's the lyrics. You kill me, the artist. I got a Letterman sweater with a letter on front in football and track. All right, artist, and what's the name of that song? Here's a new song for this one. Here's the lyrics. I thought it was forever. I thought it would last. Got to try to make it a page of my past. All right, what's that song, and what artist or group did that one? See, we're into the football season and everything. Here's what I'm looking for. Who got their nose broke by a football on this show? And hint, Greg is the one who threw the football that broke this person's nose. All right, that one shouldn't be too hard. And for my sports question, skipping with a football theme now, you know, last weekend, David Akers kicked a 63-yard field goal, tying the longest field goal in the NFL. But what is the record for the longest field goal attempt in the NFL, and who attempted it? They didn't make it. It was a missed field goal. But what was the longest one ever tried? And the baseball season's starting to wind down. The playoff push is coming. But still remind you, the Yokosuka Bay Stars still have some games left. If you want to go see a professional baseball game nearby over in Apama, they've got games on the 23rd. And per the schedule, it looks like the 28th, 29th, and 30th, they'll have home games. I think those are the last four home games scheduled of the regular season. So if you want to get over and see the Yokosuka Bay Stars over in Apama, you still have some opportunity for that. With that all said, there's CFAY as usual. Good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great weekend, CFAY.